guys, is everything is recorded, and I'm waiting for anyone to challenge me in court that I'm lying. I'm really looking forward. Shikaneni nyinyi wote. Niliwaita hapa na nikamwambia na nimwambia mada. And that one is not changing. It is not changing. I'm not changing my statements. It is the same as it is. I'm sorry I was struggling to listen, and I thought that actually the audio is being picked properly. You guys can listen too. So the audio is there. Yes, it's not clear, but it is there. And the guy speaking here to the sister is the same guy speaking in this audio with the same number. So mimi sio mlevi na mimi sio chizi. I could have failed you on the audio or the recording, but I can tell you for free. We have our murderer. You can like it, okay, or you can leave it. Aya. This is the M-Pesa code SCG26FFR00. Confirmed. You have received 100 from Zelek Alfonso of 0741-54-11, number 2 za mwisho zisemi. Okay? But that is the number, Zelek Alfonso. Kwa TikTok anajita Zelek Momani Alfonso. Same person. Huko kwa scene, mungesikia audio ni venye msikizi vizuri, kwa scene aliambia mtu wa pikipiki, toka uende. Wakati watu walianza kusema, au watu wawili wamepita hapa wakitukanana na kizungu, Zelek Momani na Brian Chira. I wish actually... Anyway, ni sawa. I must move on. Kwa nini nitakufa juu ya audio hajacheza vizuri? Mtasonga na huko mwenye mtaki kusikia. It's your business, but I can tell you for free. I am not a mad person, I'm a parent. I have boys. And whatever I'm speaking about, I know it 100%. If I can be arrested to go and produce this, I will produce it again and again and again, and I will say the same thing over and over. Oh, time. Time ni sangapi? Alimtumia Zelek Alfonso, alimtumia hii on 16th mwezi wa 3 2024 at 2:53 a.m. 2:53 a.m. That is the time. At 2:53 a.m. That is the time Zelek Alfonso Momani alituma pesa. For those asking the time. Okay? So, sawa? Yes. Oh, code. Code ni SCG. SCG26FFRO0. SCG26FFRO0. Okay? Have you understood? Ama nisome kama nisome code. Sun, cry, goat, 2, 6, frog, fish, Ryan, ostrich, 0. Alibebwa na 150 kwa sababu ya distance alafu ilikuwa usiku. Huyo jamaa anaelezea vizuri sana. Unfortunately the audio is disturbing, but he's explaining very well. Okay, he's explaining very well kila kitu. Anasema alikuwa ametisha 200, but this guy akasema anabebwa go mpaka pale na 150 bob. Na 150, unaelewa? So 150 hapa kwa huyu mama yai, kwa wale wamesikiza kidogo. Kwa huyu mama yai, huyu jamaa walibagina hapo. So alimpatia 50 bob cash. Na akamtumia 100. That is the Zelek Momani. Alituma 100. And it is here recorded. Nimesema code ni SCG26FFRO0. O na 0 ni tofauti. O ni sound. 0 ni number. That is why I'm saying O0. So SCG26FFRO0. Time 2:53 a.m. Date 16th of March 2024. Go and check if I'm saying a lie here. I'm not lying to anyone. What was the motive? This is what we need. All these are kinapita, kinagidaika, nini, nini. If this person is arrested, we will know so many things. Instead of defending him and making a joke out of me, we should actually look into this. Because the next person, we don't know who. Umenelewa? What time was the body found? Hey, walikuja kutuambia hapa mambo ya saa 8 mchana. You think I'm lying about the code? Thank you so much. Msana Zamar, that code is valid. Yes, guys, check if I'm lying. I'm not lying to you. I know they are making a fun out of me and they're making people look stupid. I am not joking. I am not saying a lie. Check the code if I'm lying. I'll withdraw for 50. Usiku. Is there anyone who has seen these things? I'm not joking. Okay? Check. Check if I'm lying about the code. I'm not lying about anything. Guys, they will make fun out of me. They will insult me. They will call me names. And they will call me a liar. I know they are going to make a fuss out of this. Tell them, sue him. Tell them, dare them. Okay, to the watchdog, I'll say mawongo, sue him. Sue him, mtu ashikwe, atolewe kwa streets, aache kusumbua watu na mawongo. Sue him, ashikwe. Tell them that. Dare them. Dare them. I'm telling you. The code is real. Name and the code is valid. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you guys for checking. Sini nyinyi mmecheck? Is it me? Is it me? So, mnataka kusema pia Safaricom nimeenda nika change vitu. To fit the viewers. Is it me who has changed? Okay. I can't give you a code and then you go confirm and then sasa pia Safaricom nilienda nikaongea, hey manzi, I can be very powerful if I can go to Safaricom and then say this code. Check the dates. It is the same thing and I've kept on saying this since day one. It's not a lie. This guy is our murderer. And on the scene, aliita mtu wa nduthi awanekane atiendi amemwangusha. Mnasikia? Huyu mtu akasema niliwa drop hapa 1 hour ago. Nilidrop hapa watu 1 hour ago na sio hapa. Hiyo audio imeniangusha. Na sio hapa, uko. Uko petrol station, sijui ni petrol station gani hiyo. Unaona? Sio hapa pale huyu jamaa anasema. Huyu jamaa aseme pale ametoa. Sasa mtu mwingine kumbe walimit na kina Chira na huyo Ozalek wakigombana wakiongea kizungu. So huyo jamaa kakuja kwa sina hao watchman wakuja kusema hao watu wamepita hapo wakitukanana wakiongea na sauti kubwa kwa Kiingereza kizungu mingi mingi. Hatujaona gari kipita hapa. Mnaelewa? Everything is on record. Unfortunately, I hope you can speak the same things. Sikia. Vipi speaker? Guys, I'm trying. This is the audio that has failed to play.
Akisema umemwibia simu yake.
Kwenye barabara hapo ya club. Ndugu. Hapo kwenye ya club.
Oh, Branchira ako nje ya club.
Ya club.
Yes.
Hapo kwenye hiyo kwenye barabara. Yo hapo kwenye barabara.
Oh, opposite the club.
So.
Pause. Unasikia? Hapo anamuuliza Zeleka anauliza Branchira, ulitoka lini huko kwa Babati? Ulitoka lini huko? Ebu rewind tu kidogo. Sikizeni na masikio zenu.
Ulitoka lini huko?
Play
again. Ulitoka lini huko? Na sasa nani wewe kupia? Maana huko ndio.
Unasikia?
How
you can be an answer for that? Hiyo ni kunini? Unasikia twangu? This was like Mumanyi was asking Chira. Chira mwenyewe umesikia hapo huyu jamaa akisema Chira walimpata kwa barabara akilia, wameniibia simu yangu, wameniibia simu yangu. That is why Eriko alikuwa anajifanya mlevi. Kuna huyo mwingine alikuwa anaita Waria, the person you have not seen the face to date, Vin. Okay? Sasa mimi ndio nilikuwa nasema Chira analia. Si hawa ndio walimpata kwa set. Huyu mtu akamshika mkono, kuja twende unionyesha wanyama kuibia. Wakaingia kwa club wakapata wale vijana missing, hakuna mtu. Na walikuwa najifanya ati walimleta kwa nduthi ya pande nduthi, alafu wa wakarudi kulewa ati after alikataa. Uongo. Sindio mwenye nduthi? People, listen. I'm not here to tarnish anyone's name. I just called all of them here to tell them the truth. Unfortunately, many of them are making a joke even right now as we speak. Tizian is very busy playing matches. And he doesn't even bother about hearing what has happened or what has been found out. He's busy playing matches. Peter Kioji has become a DCI to interrogate me. Gregor is making insults and making fun of me. Mwiti has become a lawyer. Babati was nowhere to be seen. But I can tell you the truth, guys. I am of sober mind. I am an adult, a parent, who is just trying to say the truth. I will not sit down and see my neighbor's son being killed and I keep quiet. The next one, they will be looking for mine. So mtanisame. Okay? Mtanisame. Oh, yeah, baby. Mtanisame. Guys. So mainly may come to apologize on that audio. It needs a lot of work. I think I will work on it myself and try to fix it. Okay. What was the benefits of killing him? Probably money laundering. Me, I'm just thinking of money laundering. I don't believe they just killed him for nothing. I don't. Mbona mtu alikuulize ulitoka kwa Babati lini? Mbona? Which means this guy knew. Na mnasikia mtu nduthi anasema vizuri. Alisema ati, oh, beshi yangu, vipi Chira, ulitoka huko lini? Alikuwa nasikiza wakiconverse. It's not my words. It's our first witness and key witness of what transpired. I know, of course, the very person who can say the truth of what happened is Chira, God, or the devil. Chira, God, or the devil. The three do know exactly what happened. But unfortunately, Chira is not out here to speak for himself. Neither is God going to speak for you on behalf of Chira or the devil. But I can tell you, the person who carried them, with what he experienced, this guy knows what is happening. Babati knows Mumanyi. Money laundering aje sielewi. Money laundering ina happen hivi. Utapata kuna mikora inataka pesa yoshwe. Pesa inaoshwe hivi. So as Kenyans are fundraising, wengine pia watajifanya huko ndani wanafanya nini? Wana fundraise. Umenielewa? So hiyo pesa itafika kona fulani usikie, ni aje bro, nilituma mita moja ama nilituma 700,000, hiyo 700,000 fanye vichukua 150. Hii pesa ingine rusha huku, yako ni mbao. Umenielewa? So, I suspect there could be as a result of my, I'm not saying that is the 100% answer. That one I'm not sure. But I'm just asking, ni kama tu wewe venye unauliza. Then what could be the motive? What could be the motive? Is it money laundering? Because TikTok, we know, TikTok is the only wash app in the world that is very easy to wash your money. Manelewa. Manelewa. I will say, Amina, I will disappoint you about the DCI. After even giving this evidence, all of it, they asked me if I can produce a family member who is a complainant. I was trying to reason with them so much, you know. I was trying to argue like, what if Chira was a street boy and we don't know the family members, you know? Would you still ask me as an interested person that I saw this street boy being killed, will you still ask me where are the parents to complain about it? I tried to reason, then they said, but the family is there, they buried their son and they're not complaining.
So you coming in and complaining as an individual with all these evidences. By the way, let me tell you, the DCI said, yani these officers, not the DCI, the officers agreed, and like they agreed 100% with me. But they just asked me one thing. If you were just even a distant relative to Brian Chira, bro, kitu tungeanza kesho. That is what they told me the first time I went there. First time I went there is after I had written what we call anonymous letter, asking or requesting this matter to be checked. So they ask you for further information on the same. But as we sat down with these officers, they just told me, kama shoshone za kuja complain, if there is any other family member na feel EO2 plus this evidence, bro, in case it has a question. So I felt bad, by the way. And the fact that I'm bringing you these evidences is that not that I didn't go to the DCI, I went. Not that I didn't tell them your case, I went. By the way, niuliwambia wakati nilienda huko, pia... Thank you so much, Amal Talks. The same time, kesi ya Nyako ilikuwa inaendelea. Nyako, kuna watu walileak video zake za uke wake, sawa sawa. Then kuna watu pia walitoanisha statements za M-Pesa, za transactions za Nyako. There were those two cases. But the one which were, they were very interested, as a person who reveals some things, they also asked me to provide with a little bit of information on how to track or to trace the persons who released the nudes of Nyako. And I helped with that. I remember I told you this, that guys. Okay? If I was just creating these stories up, I don't even think I could remember. We also talked about Nyako, and I helped with the information so that they can easily track down ours on Mekwaki post these videos as the first releasers of the videos to the public. You know? Because when you release Kwanza Kwanza, they're the only ones who can help trace. Okay? Who can help trace to the changa pesa lawyer. Wow. Have you tried to look for the grandfather? I'm telling you, it was planned that I should be stoned and beaten up and be stabbed. Should I be seen? Muliona si kuenda kwa... Tuli have kutumia proxies. Si kuenda kwa nani? Si kuenda kwa mochari. Si kuenda kwa matanga. Hata kwa scene. Nilionekana mara moja the next day. Ikakuwa planned that I'm not supposed to be seen anywhere. I'm against fundraising. I wasn't against any fundraising. I was not just satisfied with what I was being given as the reason... Oh, why Chira is dead. That is the only problem. I did not have, and I still do not have problem with any one of them. I am not against Baba T. I'm not against the Gideka. I'm not against Mweti. I'm not against Peter Kyoi. He's my friend, but he's a fool. I am not against who else? I'm not against anyone. I'm just like no. I have followed this up and I have found out my answers. And these answers is what I have shared with the authorities. I've shared with Kenyans right now. Sina kitu ya kuwaficha na sioni kuna haja ya kuwaficha. For now, it seems like accusations. But if they are looked into it, trust me, the government does not work with the truth. Iyo truth yako kanayo. They will only work with facts. They will only work with facts. And trust me, hata huyo mtoto akafukuliwa sahi, labda waende watuanishe wafunje vunje. Labda waende watuanishe wafunje vunje. But hata huyo mtoto akafukuliwa sahi, I can tell you for free. Whatever you are being told, sijui nini, oh, sijui, hizo zote ni stories za jaba. Umenielewa? No, msiende kuangusha account ya mtu. Please, don't do that. Don't try kuangusha account ya babatalisha. If I know you did that, and I know you are on my life, I will block you. Musiende kuangusha. That is not how you find justice. You suspect people and you want to kill them. Hata yo zelek momanyi zinawambia. Stories zake zote zinatulead to kwa one murderer. Who of course it's him. Akona account hapa TikTok. Mbona mwi drop? Account imefanya nini? Watalani na Baba T? Labda, alikuwa natetea hawa watu. Let us give him a benefit of a doubt. Labda alikuwa natetea hawa watu. Though I don't trust that, but labda alikuwa anaongea on their behalf kwa sababu hiyo ndio information yeye kama Baba T alipata na akaitumia kuelezea wa Kenya. Mnanisikia? So, rushing to ati bring her down his account or sijui nini, going insulting him, please don't do that. That is not me. That is not how we do things here. We know how Kidaika works. He insults people, he calls them names, he does everything he does. We know if you cross line ya Kioi, atakutukana mpaka, yani mpaka angalia nyuma ujiulize, ni mimi naambiwa ama kuna mtu mwingine. We know how they operate. Let us not lower ourselves to that level. Ati mnaenda kuangusha account ya Baba T. Why? Please don't.
Don't. Kuna so much memory hapo ya mtoto wake, wife wake. And I think that is good, he can hold on to that. But bringing down the account, don't do that. Don't do that. Mimi nimepoteza account, najua uchungu wa kupoteza account. That's what I'm just saying, respectively. No, that is not how we find justice. That is not how we find justice. Please watch an account yake. Okay? Sawa. No. Get a lawyer. Anzeni kuchanga. Ndio yo pay bill hapo. Pay bill ni PayPal. PayPal ni PayBull. Anzeni kuchanga, tutafute lawyer kesho. Mutume. Endeni mchange huko. Mulete hizo pesa. Endeni mchange huko. Mulete hizo pesa. Hapa sichangishi. Sorry. Endeni mchange huko. Mulete pesa. Yes, niaje, no, never mind.
Usiogope hata katululu tu itasikika. Unanisikia? Well, nisa kubetu kitu moja. Pali umefika, you're very right. And you yourself unajiambia uko right, right?
Yes, 100%.
Mimi, I can repeat, siku wa Kenya nikiona hizi story zote. But, niki follow up, 100%, Chira aliuliwa. Na menyalimua, ni hawa tu unasema, lakini Kenya unasahau ni kuna higher powers, sawa? Kama serikali hawezi ingilia mtu ameuliwa, cause in every place kwa hii dunia, hata kama mtu ameuliwa, kama familia yake hawezi kakuja ku find justice, kuna ile prosecution which is the government. The government has to find justice for huyo mtu amekufa. So assuming Chira ana family, ana anyone, so who's gonna find justice for him? So inamaanisha serikali haijawahi kapata law enye inaweza support mtu mwenye ana familia. So in short, wewe ukiuliwa, ukikufa, wewe ni kama chokora. So that is just as hiyo weka kando. At the end of the day, kama familia yake haiwezi ingilia, lazima kuna mtu mwenye akona very higher powers mwenye anasema usijaribu. And at the end of the day, everything inasemekana hapo, mimi naweza kukuambia from my own point of view, my own opinion. I don't need facts. From what I'm seeing, what I just saw from my eyes, au watu wote na mention wako tu sawa pali wako, hizo ni places zao umewaweka, lakini pali umefika umekwamia hapo, jiulize mbona nimekwama na ni nani amenikwamisha? Ni serikali.
That is the bitter truth.
Exactly. Kwa hivyo, at the end of the day, usisahau, me, I'm a very loving human being. Napenda any person, uwe gay, uwe whatever, LGBTQ, HDS, TV, whatever, it doesn't matter, right?
GHC.
Exactly. But at the end of the day, usisahau, Kenya, the culture, the society, tutakubali TikTok tuodezi ujinga zote. Lakini at the end of the day, truth remains. No one, no person will accept that one in public, whatever they are trying to do now on TikTok, right? So, hakuna mtu atakubali hiyo Kenya, hata politicians, pastor. Kama hiyo ndo ilifanya wapigane na Americans, itakuwaji sasa atijuya Chira, uyu shoga tu amekufa pale. Hiyo ni kama umeuangurue. Nani atashugulika? Who will care? They will not even think about any human dignity or virtue or whatever. It doesn't concern them. It's all about power. And as we are, hii kitu naongelea, you're seeing it on a very lower level. But where I am, this is politics. LGBTQ, HDS, TV, imekuwa ikitangazwa kwanzia like 3-4 years ago. Hakuna mtu anaitaka. Wakitaka kuinflict, Kenya paliko isha kula pesa LGBTQ, HDS, TV.
Wewe usilete hapa politics wewe.
Mimi siletu politics. Out of finyo. Mbona tu usichokoze mtu yoyote, you know, at the end of the day, you're entitled to say what your mind tells you to say, but you're not entitled to actually point out nani unasema. But at the end of the day, sisi wote tunataka ukweli, and even you, as you are, your name is Truth Watchdog. So at the end of the day, usijichukulie tu hivyo tu hivi hivi ni kama hata kama utauliwa, by the way utaamka another lifetime, uendelee tu na Truth Watchdog, because that is what God actually anointed in you or inflicted in you. You have to find the truth. So our church wamekuja hapa for the past I don't know how many minutes, ile time walikuwa unawaita walikuja, apparently for the first time I had every noisemaker on TikTok keeping quiet. Nilikuwa mpaka nashangaa, like, oh, okay. How is it that everyone here who is a noisemaker and they talk trash and everyone, they're just quiet, now they want to listen. After listening, they really want to now know what you have at hand for them to confirm if it is really what is what and how and whatever. So, at the end of the day, mi naweza kukwambia, because of your 14, mi nakupenda tu juu ya watoto wako 14 wenye ulitoa pale, ulitoa sijui ni wapi.
Watoto ni wengi sana kwa streets. Hata kama ukitaka tu.
Just exactly. A matter of time you get there. Due to hiyo, me on my own mind, which is very godly and very clear and very honest, it's either you just decide and be okay, because finding truth, hata Yesu alikuja kuturescue na akauliwa, kwanza alikuwa crucified, maka sasa tunamlilia. Sasa wewe, si utakufa leo in the next 3 months, sawa?
Achidwe kabisa, mimi nakufa at 99 years.
Exactly. So the truth, you're for the truth. But then, this truth is actually more deeper than you actually think. Because Kenya haiezi kataka ikuwe sasa influenced na izi mavitu zinendelea on TikTok. Vitu mingi zinendelea on TikTok. Mi pali niko, by the Truth Watchdog, ni normal. Prostitution illegal. Hakuna kitu wapa ni shida. Yani, everything is okay. That's why utaona watoto wanapiga kelele hapo sijua kwa Ujerumani wanaongea mnafikiria ni big deal. It's not a big deal, because the system allows it, the society allows it. So ukwe shoga usikwe shoga, no one cares. Uibe usiibe utaenda jela. It's that simple, you know. But then where I come from, there are taboos, there are rules, there are regulations, there are limits. And if you break the limits of the society, then the government has to actually take control of that. Because wewe ukikufa sahi, watoto wako wasiende kuprosecute ati nani ameua baba yangu. At the end of the day, the government has to send a prosecutor to fight for you. That means wakienda kotini watasema the government against the person who killed you. Because hauna watu. So, Chira's case, if the family doesn't want to do anything, the government still has the authority or the audacity to actually say, this is not right, let us follow up. But, question number kita baki hapo pali, why is no one following up? So, ikifika hapo, kuwa mjanja, alafu jambia, Mungu, Yesu, nisaidia tu nile watoto na amani, mpate pesa na amani, I politics ni ngumu. Watakuingiza kwa moto, jiwewe wewe uko truth, ndio maana hujashikwa. Hao wenye wameshaingizwa box, wote wameshatiwa vidole hivi tayari. Ndio maana walikuwa hapo ile time ukiwaita wote. I was online, ilikuwa tu naona unawaita. Kila mtu alikuja akanyamaza ndee. Ni kama jaiongea maisha yake yote hata ajui kutukanana. Maswali. When that one happens, you have to also go deep into yourself, into your intuition. Ask God, is going on here? You know, if it's not your fight to fight, you're a very kind person, you're really responsible for those children you're taking care of. Follow it up, but then make sure you're doing it in a very clever and systematic way that you'll also protect yourself and the people that you're there with, or the kids that you're taking care of. Hiyo ndo naweza kuambia kama familia Chira, aitake kufuatilia. Don't let your conscience kill you because you didn't follow that one up. You did it. You've done it. You're actually on the right track. But shida ni pale umefika utakuwa mapo juu sasa wewe kama serikali ni serikali utakula juu serikali na wewe serikali. Wewe mko kwa serikali ndio malize serikali, sawa? In short, there are people who, there's no way you can tell me hakuna mtu mpaka sahi ati wewe pale umefika ndio umediscover truth. Hii ni kitu CID kishika tu hivi dakika mbili, flying squad imepata hii issue ya Chira within 24 hours. It didn't happen because the family apparently didn't follow up. But why did the family not follow up? Jushira akona a certain kind of opposite to the society, which apparently in Kenya it's not allowed. Ini kitu mpaka Uganda una you have to pay 10,000, I don't know how much, and go to prison. Unajua vitu zingine, you people are taking it literally. Ni kama ni story. Mbona si wewe ama nani yako kujiwa kaambiwa hivi na hivi? You know, Kenya is a sanctuary for anyone who is in trouble. It is a sanctuary. They accept everyone. They take everyone. Kenya is a loving country. But then, when you now start to act like you're in Europe or you're in America, then you'll be told like, my friend, calm down. Hakuna vile watu 20,000 wanajina kuzika huko Chira na sijui Mudavadi aligufa, sijui nani wa aligufa na alila kuzika na watu 200. Uwe sitari ni president wa Kenya. Tunakwanya na president wenye rainbow. You know, come on. Just think on another perception. Just don't be on that thing of insisting that utapata nani alimuua. Mwenye alimuua, you know very well. Kama amesema sijui hivi na hivi, you know very well. At the end of the day, the puzzle will always find the piece of the puzzle that is missing. But if it is not to work to find the piece of the puzzle that is missing, truth watchdog. Hawa watu wako 14, mi ndo napenda, hata si wajui lakini napenda. Jumu sema, mtu yangu akikuwa mkubwa, mta adopt watu hata kama 15, yani ndo nisikuwe lonely, likuwa tu na watu every time. So with that in mind, you have a purpose in this life, and it's you to choose either to stay on the truth that you know 100% is going to put you on your rest, which is you're not going to rest because you're a living spirit. Utaletwa tu bado hii dunia tena tu kuendelea na hiyo spirit yako. Makelis kutapata justice. So before that one happened, achana na watu wapige kelele. Hata hii life, find some interesting things on giving it to them. Otherwise, the energy they're going to send to you, they're coming to you, they're going to be putting your children in trouble. You don't need that. You don't deserve that. Kama familia Chira haijali, don't put yourself down because of these things or whatever. Ifikirie kwa akili yako, jua umesema ukweli yako. Watu wakienda jana, if people are going to hell, you won't be part of them because you already said your truth. So at the end of the day, it's all about your heart and your mind and what you actually think about a human being. If you've done your part, tenda mema nenda zako. The rest, usibishane na mtu yoyote. Don't even argue. Don't even try to find justice. If no human being can find justice for you, there's only God who can actually put that justice into practice, which will happen anyway. So you don't have it. Aufai kuwari. Unafai tu kujua I. It has to be paid. And if Chira was a godly person, as much as he was confused, karma is a bitch. It has to come back. So just chill. Don't stress yourself. These people are going to drain your energy. They're going to finish you up. Ata wata kumaliza, juu kuna energy enough ya kuhold. Yeah? But then, instead of wasting your energy on this, you've done your part. You've done it right. You're okay. Your conscience is clear. Your spirit is okay. Your soul is at peace. You don't need to apologize to anyone. If you're okay with that, let it be. Let them now continue. Whatever you've said, let it go from there. Ivo tu. Yani mi tunakwambia, hata sijui ya social media or whatever. Mi si need followers, si need anything, si need whatever. I'm just here because I like what you do and I hear what you say and I resonate. If you cannot resonate, then that means you're not making sense. Sikia huyu nandra kufa hapa bure.
Ndo msaidia.
So, truth watch dog, keep the job up. Mi wacha ni toke. Another day, but think very deep. Go deep into it. Kama serikali imekataa kunakwambia tafuta mama yake, baba yake na wamekufa. Watataka kwa mauti wakuje wamtetee.
Kwera. Sante. But then she's making a lot of sense.